Here we are going to do a numerical. First of all, I read the question. A tank of uniform cross section has two orifices, each of 50 mm diameter, in one of the vertical sides, provided at 2.4 meter and 6 meter above the bottom of the tank. Find the time required to lower the depth of water from 9 meter to 4.5 meter. The tank is 1 meter square in area and coefficient of discharge is 0.62. Now we write the given parameter. What is given in the question? Diameter of the orifice is given. There are two orifices, each having diameter D equal to 50 mm. We can convert this in meter. This is 0.05 meter. And we can find area of a orifice. This is small a equal to pi by 4 into 0.05 square. This is 0.001963 meter square. And other given, one orifice is 2.4 meter above and another orifice is 6 meter above. Free surface of water is 9 meter. Nine meter above bottom of the tank. Lower orifice height is given as 2.4 meter. Upper orifice height is given as 6 meter. This is above the bottom of the tank. And coefficient of discharge is given. This is CD is 0.62. We have to find the time to fall level of water from free surface to 4.5 meter below the tank. Here now we level this given data in the question. This is free surface is 9 meter above bottom of the tank and upper orifice is 6 meter above this bottom and lower orifice is 2.4 meter. This height is 2.4 meter. We have to find time to fall level of water from this free surface to the 4.5 meter below the free surface. We have to calculate the time to fall level of water from this free surface to 4.5 meter below the free surface. Let this is 4.5 meter from here to here. This is center of upper orifice. We can label the name here. Let this is A and B this is and this is C, D, E, F and here is G, H. We have to find the time to fall off level of water from this AB to EF. EF is 4.5 meter below the free surface. For that, we have to calculate this total time to fall level of water from free surface to EF in two steps. We first calculate the time to fall level of water from AB to CD and then after CD to EF. And we add these two values to get total time. First of all, we calculate here. Let at any instant, the water level is at height H1 above CD. This is the level of water. And in small interval of time, the water level fall by small height DH. DH1. Here we calculate this numerical in two steps. Here first step. First step is to reduce level of water from AB to CD. For that, we consider height h1 at any instant of time. Let at any instant of time h1 be the level of water above the upper orifice and dh1 be the small fall in level of water in small interval of time dt1. You can see in figure here. So that volume of fall here must be equal to volume out from these two orifices. Volume of waterfall is this area of the tank into small height dh. Area of cross section of tank is given in the question. Area of tank is given as A equal to 1 meter square. Let area of tank is capital A. This is A into dh. This must be equal to the discharge from this upper orifice plus discharge from this lower orifice. Discharge from upper orifice is CD into A into root under 2G. We have to take height above this upper orifice. This is H1. And discharge from lower orifice is CD into small a. Area of orifice is small a. Both orifice have the same area, same dimension, that is 50 mm and root under 2g, and height above this lower orifice is this 6 minus 2.4, that is 3.6 plus h1, and this is discharge. We have to multiply with time. Time is dt1, small time here. We can take common here, this CD into area of orifice also common, and root under 2G is common, and dt1 is also common here. This is dt1, and we have remaining is this h1 plus 3.6 plus root under h1, and we have here A into dh1. Here we put negative sign. This negative sign indicates with increase of time the water level fall. So we separate here dt1 and we calculate total time t1 by integrating the equation. This total time t1 is equal to A into dh1 upon CD into small a into root under 2g, and we have h1 plus 3.6 in root under plus root under h1. Now we integrate this equation from this height to this level. We have to take head over the orifice. This is dt1. Here we have dt1 equal to minus a into dh1 upon cd into a into root under 2g, and this root under h1 plus 3.6 plus root under h1. We have to integrate this equation. For that, here in denominator we have root, so we remove this root from this denominator. For that we have to multiply it with opposite sign, so that we can have here a square minus b square. Let's multiply this with root under h1 plus 3.6 minus root under h1 upon root under h1 plus 3.6 minus root under h1. Or dt1 equal to minus a dh1 upon cd into a into root under 2g into this is, if we take this root under h1 plus 3.6 as a and root under h1 as b, then we have a square minus b square here. This is, if we open this in a square minus b square, we have h1 plus 3.6 minus h1, and in upper side we have root under h1 plus 3.6 minus root under h1. Now we integrate this equation easily. This h1, h1 is having opposite sign, we can cancel here, and we can integrate this. We can integrate this equation from here, this free surface to this center of the orifice. For that we have to find the this height AC. AC height is this total height 9 meter minus here 6 meter is 3 meter. 3 meter is the height here AC. Here we have to integrate this equation from this 3 to 0. This total height is 3, AC height is 3. If we take head over the water, this is from 3 meter to 0 meter. This is t1 equal to integration sign. This is 3 to 0 minus a dh1 upon cd into a into root under 2g, and here 3.6 remaining. We have here root under h1 plus 3.6 minus root under h1. This time total time t1 to fall level of water from AC AB to CD is t1 equal to, if we remove this negative sign, we can change our limit here 0 to 3, and now we integrate this. Here area of cross section of a tank is constant, and coefficient of discharge is constant, area of orifice is always constant, this root under 2g is constant, and 3.6 also constant. So we have to integrate this only. If we integrate this, this is h1 plus 3.6 to the power 1 by 2 plus 1 3 by 2 upon 3 by 2 minus h1 to the power 3 by 2 upon 3 by 2. Limit from 0 to 3. Here we can put the value. The area of cross section and time is given as 1 meter square. So this is 1 upon CD is coefficient of discharge 0.62 into area of orifice is 0.001963. इंटू रूट अंडर टू इंटू वैल्यू ऑफ जी एक्सेलरेशन ड्यू टू ग्रेविटी 9.81 इंटू 3.6 एंड वी हैव टू पुट दिस अपर लिमिट एंड लोअर लिमिट. इफ वी पुट दिस अपर लिमिट 3 यार 3 प्लस 3.6 6.6 टू द पावर 3/2 एंड 3/2 इज रिमेनिंग हेयर. सो हेयर इज 2/3 माइनस वी हैव टू पुट दिस 3 एंड वी हैव 2/3 3 टू द पावर 3/2 माइनस नाउ वी हैव टू पुट दिस 0. इफ यू पुट 0 हेयर दिस इज 2/3 3.6 टू द पावर 3/2 और t1 इक्वल टू दिस वी कैन कॉमन टेक कॉमन 2/3 आउटसाइड. दिस इज व्हेन वी कैलकुलेट दिस आउटसाइड वैल्यू वी गेट 51.52. वी कैन टेक कॉमन 2/3 इंटू एंड व्हेन वी कैलकुलेट दिस 6.6 इन कैलकुलेटर वी गेट 6.6 टू द पावर 3/2 वी गेट हेयर 16.95 माइनस दिस 3 टू द पावर 3/2 इज 5.19 एंड वी हैव रिमेनिंग दिस 3.6 टू द पावर 3/2 दिस इज इक्वल टू 6.83 एंड दिस टोटल टाइम t1 इज इक्वल टू 169.27 सेकेंड. योर फर्स्ट स्टेप इज फिनिश्ड t1 टाइम टू फॉल फ्रॉम ए बी टू सी डी. नाउ वी हैव टू कैलकुलेट टाइम टू फॉल फ्रॉम सी डी टू ई एफ. वी नोट दिस वैल्यू हियर t1 इज 169.27 सेकेंड. Now we calculate time to fall level of water from CD to EF, that is 4.5 meter below the free surface. Second step this is. In second step, we again let here DS2 above this second orifice. Here let at any instant of time we let here this is the free surface at any instant while falling water level from CD to EF and we have here small height DS2 fall in small interval of time DT2 and let this is S2. In similar procedure we calculate T2 here. Here has to be the height of the water level at any instant of time and this D has to be the fall in level of water in small interval of time D2. Here now we equate like previous volume of fall in small interval of time DT2, that is area of the tank into small height DS2. This is volume of fall which must be equal to volume out from this orifice. Volume out from this orifice is discharge from this orifice into time. This is CD into area of orifice into root under 2G, and head over the orifice is just to, this is discharge into time GT2. Here we put negative sign. This negative sign indicate when time increases, this small height decreases. Height decreases, so negative sign is introduced. From here, we separate GT2. This is minus A into DS2 upon CD into A into root under 2G. And this is S to the power 1 by 2. Now we can integrate this equation. Integrating form. Here we are going to take the limit. We have to take limit always from the head over the orifice. And we are going to calculate time to fall level of water from CD to EF. For that we need a head over the orifice GS to CD. The head over the orifice, let GC is 6 minus 2.4. This is 3.62, and we have to find time to fall level of water from CD to EF. For that we have to take height, this EG. This height is, this is 4.5, EF level is 4.5 meter from this free surface and bottom surface. This is EF line is at middle. So AD here is this 4.5 minus 2.4. This is 2.1. Here we have to integrate now. This is 2.1. If we integrate this equation, we get T2 here. This is minus, here we have integration sign. This is 3.6, 2.1. A into DS2 upon CD into small a into root under 2G. When we take this s to the power minus 1 by 2 in numerator, we have power is negative. That is s to the power minus 1 by 2. If we change limit here, your negative sign is removed. This is property of definite integral. And this is area of tank is constant, and CD coefficient of discharge is constant, A or area of orifice is constant, root under 2G is constant. And we have to integrate this s to the power minus 1 by 2 only. When you integrate this, this is s to the power minus 1 by 2 plus 1 is plus 1 by 2 upon 1 by 2. Here we have to take limit from lower limit 2.1 to upper limit 3.6. This is A into, we can put the value of all the parameter here. Area of tank is 1 square meter. Coefficient of discharge 0.62. Area of orifice 0.001963 into root under 2 into 9.81. And this is s to the power 1 by 2 is root under 3.6 minus root under 2.1. Here 1 by 2 is remaining. So we take outside here. This is into 2. When we calculate this, we get 166.29. This is T2. We have time T1 here and T2. By adding this, we get total time to fall level of water from AB to EF. That is 4.5 meter below the free surface. And total time T is calculated as T equal to T1 plus T2. दिस इज 169.27 प्लस 166.29। दिस इज टोटल टाइम टी इज 335.41।